Hi, welcome back to this channel where we share tutorial for you to become a data pro. In this video, I'm planning to try out the embedding feature in Google Data Studio. If you saw the announcement or release note back in October last year, you have probably known that we can now include a Google Map visuals in the embedded report. Embedding means we can place the dashboard or the report in our own website. So in this video, you will see me working on this for my own website, and you will get to learn more about Data Studio and how amazing it is if you know how to make the best out of this tool. If you have visited my website before, you will know that I have this simple About Me page. So today, I'm thinking of generating a heat map in Data Studio to show the geo distribution of my existing audience on this YouTube channel. If you don't know already, Data Studio has this connector for YouTube analytics data, and it's completely free. Since I have already connected to my account, I can start creating charts right away. The current report is actually a work in progress dashboard that I created to analyze my channel analytics. I would actually start in a new report instead of creating on top of the existing one because I don't want to make the current report public. So the quickest way to do this would be to create a duplicate of the existing report. So how do we make a copy of the current report? To do that, we'll go to the menu on top and look for File and select Make a Copy. Then you will see a Windows prompt you to select a data source for this new report. Since I'll be using my own data, which is the same as the original data source, I'll just remain as it is. Once you have confirmed, hit Copy Report. Now, in the new report, we'll start by deleting the pages that we don't need to show in the embedded reports or the pages that we don't want my visitors to see. To delete a page, we'll access the three vertical dots on the right by hovering on the report page's title and select delete. I also found that if you have a hidden page, you will need to unhide the pages first before you can delete it. Besides, if you have the pages within a section, which is a fairly new feature by Data Studio, you will need to delete the nested pages before you could delete the entire section. If you want to know more about the nested navigation, I actually have a tutorial video on that topic which I'll make sure to link in the description below. For this report, I'll only need the page audience demographic, so I'll continue to remove the pages. Once I have deleted all other pages, I'll move the audience demographic page from the current section and proceed to delete the section since we no longer need it. Next, I'll rename the report and I added this public prefix in front of the title to make sure I know that this dashboard is open to public. I kind of hope we have folders feature in Data Studio to organize all our dashboard, but while we are waiting for that, I think the best way to organize the files is to label the dashboard accurately so it's easier to find the report from the search bar. As mentioned earlier in the video, I wish to show the geo distribution of my audience. So right now you can see there are two geo charts here. The blue one is showing the geo distribution by the number of subscribers, whereas the yellow map shows the watching hours by regions. I decided to go with the geo distribution by subscriber count. Hence, I'm removing the charts at the bottom. To do that quick, we'll be selecting the entire area and hit delete on your keyboard. Next, we're going to change the geo chart to the Google Map chart because part of the purpose of doing this is to try out the new feature for you all. To switch the chart, we don't have to recreate the chart. Simply click on the existing one and head to the property panel to expand the header. You'll see a bunch of chart selections here. We'll choose Google Map Chart. Google Map Chart has the controls at the right-hand side of the visual. This makes the map interactive, so zooming in a specific area or a specific country is made super easy for the report viewers. Unfortunately, this function is not available for draw map, which is why sometimes Google Map is a better option if you wish to drill down further to find out more details about a region. Because the style of the map is not to my liking, so I'll go to the Style tab to customize the chart. So in the Property panel under the Style section, we can play around with different options to format the map. We have Silver, Standard, and Dark theme for the map. I decided to go with the dark theme. Next, we have some toggle sliders here to adjust the level of background details to show in the Google Map. Then we can scroll down to explore more options to customize our map. For the field map area, I decided to change the borderline to white color as I thought it would go well with the dark background. I have also set the field area density to 70% so it appears at a lighter color. Next, you can see that on the right hand side of the map, we have some view controls. These are actually customizable. We can choose to show or hide the map view controls from the property panels. So I decided to keep the full screen control available only, so I'll untick the rest. Then I hide the color legend as it looks much cleaner without that. And also I don't want the audience to see the numbers right away in the chart. I further customize the chart by adding a border shadow to the map to make it more popping up. And I will also remove the date range, because I want it to show lifetime. Now we have done with the map, but before we proceed, let's take some time to customize this table chart. First, I want to show only top 10 countries based on the number of the subscribers. So at the rows per page section, I have selected 10 maximum rows. Then I spent some time playing around with different colors and design to decide the best look for this report. And this is the final look. You would notice that I have added a button down there to let people subscribe to my channel if they came across my website. For this button, we can just add a text and format it to look like a button. If you are interested to learn how to create a text button that looks like this, I actually have a tutorial last week that teach you how to create 4 different styles of buttons in Data Studio. So feel free to check it out. And now we will customize the page dimension so we don't have extra empty space at the bottom. This is just something I like to do for better user experience in my report. Then I modified the design a little bit more. So here is the final look. Before we move on, we'll first need to allow public view access to our dashboard as the default link sharing setting is always set to off. Once we set the access to anyone on the internet can find and view, I have also selected the options below to avoid any downloading, printing or copying for my viewers as I don't want people to reuse this report. Lastly, we can click Save to save the sharing settings that we have just configured. On, we'll go to the File menu and click the very last option, Embed Report. In this window, we can choose either to have the embed code, so we could copy and paste it to our site source code, or any plugin that allows you to place the code snippet. Alternatively, we could also have the embed URL. For now, I'll select embed code because my site is generated using Hugo. So now let's click copy to clipboard to copy the entire code. Then I move on to my website source code for about me page to insert the code. So this is the first look after embedding the report into my website. So as you can see, the width is not adjusted properly. Then I'll have to adjust the width to 100% instead of fixing it at 800 pixels, so the size of the embedded report could be adjusted dynamically based on the device that the website viewers used. So that's all we can do for now, and I hope you like this kind of more casual tutorials. Feel free to drop by my website for more Data Studio map-related articles written by me. See you next time, bye bye!